Mosaic, a daily news program from Link TV, presents a selection of news reports from independent and state-controlled broadcasters from throughout the Middle East.
In Baghdad, two members from the Muslim Scholars Association were assassinated, raising fears that this may set off an ethnic war. These attacks are taking place as the deadline to kill the Briton and the two American hostages is approaching, and more than 20 other hostages are facing death if the kidnappers' demands are not met. Meanwhile, the U.S. has been bombing Fallujah, killing and wounding many people.
As assassinations in Baghdad mark another violent day in the country, these types of acts had stopped for a brief period only to surface again, further complicating the deteriorating situation in Iraq. Two members of the Muslim Scholars Association in Iraq were assassinated. Sheikh Muhammad Jadu was killed as he was leaving a mosque in the Baya neighborhood, and Sheikh Hazem El-Zaidi was killed in Sadr neighborhood as well. The Muslim Scholar Association believes that these assassinations are an attack on Iraq's national unity.
The Sunnis and the Shiites should work together to better serve the city, and in Thawra city in particular, and in Gayara, and in the inner cities and the suburbs.
Fallujah is experiencing the fiercest attacks in Iraq. U.S. airplanes are currently raiding the city. According to doctors at Fallujah's General Hospital, at least three civilians were killed and others were wounded in a U.S. air raid where at least six missiles were launched at areas believed to harbor local fighters in central Fallujah and at the northeastern side of the city.
The airplane hit Abu Shafal and the truck driver with him. They attacked the man who cleans the city.
A car bomb blew up in downtown Mosul, killing three people. The explosion occurred on a narrow street in the Wihda neighborhood, destroying a vehicle that was parked near the area and damaging neighboring buildings. It seems like the victims are gunmen who were attempting to explode a car bomb in the city. The hostage situation remains unsettled. An armed group in Iraq set a deadline to execute more than 20 hostages, including two Americans and a Briton. Meanwhile, another group is threatening to kill 10 hostages working for a U.S.-Turkish company if the company does not leave Iraq within 3 days.
The U.S. occupation forces and the Iraqi National Guard opened fire on the Al Alam office in Baghdad, damaging equipment and property in the office. This comes as part of a series of raids and harassments against the Al Alam office and its correspondents in the Iraqi capital and the holy city of Najaf. As the channel reports information about those behind the explosions and kidnappings in Iraq.
The Al Alam TV office in Baghdad was once again targeted. This time, gunfire was the language used after the office and its correspondents in many Iraqi cities were subjected to a series of raids, harassments, and detentions. The U.S. occupation forces and the Iraqi National Guard sprayed gunfire in all corners of the office, making holes in the walls, hallways, and inside rooms. The windows were broken and there was much damage. It created an atmosphere of terror and fear in the office, according to the workers who carry nothing except their important message of information.
In any case, on a daily basis, we are subjected to death.
During the latest raid, they arrested Al Alam correspondents and office workers without being given any reasons for these measures. This was in Baghdad. However, in Najaf, An Al-Alam correspondent was prevented from continuing his reporting of the events in Holy Najaf during the clashes that took place there last month. The Al-Alam correspondent, Muhammad Al-Qadim, was on the air when he was physically prevented from making a live report of the events. Yes.